Hey, it's John and Enduring Charm. So this video, we're going to talk about grouting a vertical wall, or a shower wall in this case. Now, I have a different video that I did years ago. It's gotten millions of views about how to grout. And I encourage you to check that out, especially if you feel like you need to leave a comment about how the guy at Home Depot told you to do it differently. Check out that video. Honestly, had I known at the time it would get that much attention, I would have spent a little more time on production values on it, but it is what it is, and it's still good information. So check out that video. I'll put a link in the comments to it. But I do have a floor to grout here, but the main issue I want to talk about today is the shower walls. Now, as far as applying the grout to a vertical surface like a shower wall, it's no different other than it's a vertical surface, and there are some unique things about a shower wall, mostly on this wall here where the plumbing is located. Now, I am going to give you a demonstration of all this, but I just want to talk about some techniques and things to think about before we get to that. So number one is, if the grout color on the walls is different than on the floor, make sure you cover the floor before you start grouting the walls. The main technique is we're going to start on the top of the walls and work our way down. That's because it is going to make a mess, and just get used to that idea. So as you're grouting up here, a whole bunch of grout is going to drop down and it's going to land on the tub. We are going to cover this valve so we don't muck up the valve, but you know, the excess grout is going to land in the tub. It's going to make a mess. Just get used to it. It's not a problem. We're going to clean it up in the end. Now, this particular shower, the homeowner asked me to tile all the way to the ceiling. So when we grout, there's a line between the ceiling and the tile. That grout line there, we're not going to grout that. The reason is the drywall and the tile are going to expand and contract at different rates with seasonal variation, and you're going to get cracking at that grout up there. So we're just going to use a caulk, color match caulk up there, or depending on how you tile, you may be able to just leave it alone. So no grout in that line up there. On the bottom, okay, right here where the tile meets the tub, again, no grout goes in there. We're going to clean that out and we're going to apply a silicone caulk. And again, this tub expands and contracts at a different rate than the tile, so the caulk will allow that to flex a little bit. Now, as we're grouting, inevitably what's going to happen is, you know, some of the grout's going to get in here. So we're going to work our way down to the bottom. When we get to the bottom, before I finish up, I'm going to use a piece of cardboard or almost anything you can stick in there, and just clean out the grout that ended up in that line right here. Now let's talk about this edge treatment right here. This is a bullnose tile, named because this little rounded edge right here reminds people of a bull's nose, I guess. So we are going to grout this area right here, okay? The way I do that, you notice here I've already got the finish paint on the walls. I like to do that, some other people don't, but I like to do the finish paint first. What I'm going to do is, when I grout just this area right here, okay, I'm going to have the grout just a little bit wetter than I would otherwise. And I'm just going to use my hands, because really there's no better tool. You can put on gloves if you like. And I'm just going to work that grout into that line right here, and then, you know, wipe it clean with a sponge. Now up here where the shower head comes out, there's an escutcheon plate that covers that hole, but we still want to grout in there. Now you'll notice my plumber left an iron pipe sticking out here. The iron pipe will screw into the receiver there, but it's the iron pipe itself is a little, the outside diameter is a little bigger than the shower head pipe that we're going to use later. So I can grout around this iron pipe, and then when the grout is dry, I'll unscrew this pipe, and it'll leave just a little bit of a gap up there for the shower head pipe to go in later. So that works out good. Down here where the spout comes out, again, I can grout around this. Now this copper pipe is permanent, but I can grout around this. That's fine, it won't hurt anything. This area here, I wanna cover the valve because I don't want any smudge getting in there and ruining the valve. We don't have to worry too much about this because there's a big escutcheon that goes, a plate that goes around this whole thing. So this all gets covered. Now let's talk about the corners. So do you grout the corners or do you caulk the corners? Honestly, it's a judgment call. And depending on the situation, I may go either way. If you feel the house framing is not very stable and you expect a lot of seasonal variation and, you know, a lot of movement with the framing, then I would go with caulk in the corners. If you feel it's a pretty stable installation and the corners were really well done as far as framing and you're sure about it, then you can grout. The worst that's going to happen is the grout will crack a little bit and you can always replace it later, but it is a little bit of a judgment call. In this particular case, the tile goes to the door trim. And again, door trim is wood, the tile is different material, they'll expand and contract at different rates. So we're going to caulk this area and not grout it. Now, unless you're 7 feet tall, you're probably going to have to use a step ladder to get up high. I know I have to. So I protect the bottom of the tub with a piece of cardboard. This is pretty thick cardboard, so I don't put a hole in the bottom of the tub or something. As I get to the bottom, when I'm grouting, at some point I'll remove this cardboard and then I'll just keep cleaning out the tub as I go. All right, so that's a quick review. I'm going to do some demonstration next. Before I do that, I got to get to removing all these spacers. I'll clean out any thin set that's in the joints. Anything that I see that, you know, might interfere with the grouting, I'll clean all that up, get it vacuumed, and then we can start. Just for information purposes, this is a 1/8 inch grout line. I will be using a sanded grout. If you have a thinner grout line, like a 1/16 or something like that, you can use a non-sanded grout. As far as tools and what you'll need, other than 5 gallon buckets, one bucket with a grout and one bucket with nice clean water, or sometimes you have two buckets with nice clean water, you're going to need a grout sponge. Don't use just any sponge. These sponges are, you know, specifically designed for this. They can wring out almost all the water, which is what you want. As far as applying the grout, there are different types of floats. My personal preference is this rubber gummy type of float. It's got a sharp edge to it. It's a little bit smushy, you know, it's got some gumminess to it, and the ends, one end has a you know, rounded over edge, the other end has a sharp edge, so you can get into corners if you need to. Okay, I got my thin set mixed up. This is too wet for the field tile, but I made it a little bit too wet. Why? Because I'm gonna do that edge first. Remember that bullnose edge? So after I finish the bullnose edge, I'll add a little mix to this and dry it out a little bit. So this is too wet for the field tile, but it's perfect for that edge. I'm just gonna grab this in my hand like this. It makes a mess, I know. And then, all right, so I got this in my hand. And I'm just gonna smush it in there. I know it's getting on the paint, it's fine. I know it's dropping, that's fine. Don't worry about it. I'm just gonna work it in there with my hand. I'm not pressing super hard. It's just enough to get it in there. All right, so that would finish up getting it in there. Then I'm gonna grab my sponge. And now that edge should be pretty good. I'll check there for excess. Just gonna wipe this off the paint. Pleased with it, I'll do my final wipe. Now I can start working on the inside. I gotta go all the way down, but I can start working on the inside tile next. So I start with this, and then work my way in and work my way down. All right, here's a close-up of that edge we just did. We just wanna get this part done. Don't worry about this area, we'll get that later. Just want to get this inside area right here done. Now, did you watch that other video? Let's just briefly go over sponge, right? We want this sponge damp, not wet. If you're adding water to the grout, you got a problem. So I'm going to get it cleaned off. When I start to come out, I get the whole sponge in my both hands like that. See, there's nothing more dripping out. Let go, that's enough. If you're using a real grout sponge, that's going to be good. Damp, not wet. And one more review of technique. When we get our damp sponge here, there's going to be grout here, let's say. The whole technique is, as I'm turning it. I'm twisting the sponge out like this, all right? You've got to use that technique. So if there's grout right here, I'm going to pull across, turn and pull up as I'm pulling. And that's going to have grout all here. Now that side is no good. I can flip it over and get one more side. And again, I'm pulling as I'm turning, and I'm good. And then I'll wash out the sponge. Now I know the guy at Home Depot told you to do this and to leave it for 20 minutes and then come back and then scrub it out like this and then maybe do some more like this, and then that's not necessary. That's an old school method. It just isn't necessary anymore. These grouts will do perfectly fine by what I'm telling you. We'll just make sure we get good coverage in the grout lines, really push it in there with a float, and then we're gonna do this motion like this. Everything's gonna be beautiful. And one more thing about technique, depending on how deep you want that grout line to be, if you want it to be really deep, in other words, there's kind of a concave area like that, it's a matter of aesthetics. If you want that, then you're gonna push harder on the sponge and really wipe it out. If you don't want that, you want basically a flush grout line, then you're gonna go real light on the sponge and just like that, okay? So depending on how much pressure you put on the sponge, that determines how deep that grout line goes. Okay, let's do some grouting here in the middle. The grout is dried out a little bit. Still a little on the damp side, but I'm in pretty good shape. All right. Just gonna take my float, work it in there. I'll use two hands. I really wanna make sure those grout lines are filled, so use some pressure there. Don't be shy about it. Now, how far you go, now I'm doing this for demonstration. I might go further down the wall. I'm just gonna go a little bit here. If I didn't have the camera on, I might go a little bit further, but I just wanna show you what's what. So I'm coming at it from all angles. Just making sure that's nice and deep in there. All right, then I'm just gonna take the excess on a diagonal. All right, like I said, if I didn't have the camera on, I'd probably go down a little deeper, but since I'm trying to show you here, I'll go next to the sponge. So I'm done with this. I grab my sponge. Watch my technique now, right? I'm gonna come up here and twist as I come down. Okay, twist as I come down. I'm not putting too much pressure because I want a not totally flat, but a flatter grout line. That's it. I got two swipes. Now I rinse out. Come back. All right, over here. Keeping the diagonal, I didn't get much on that one. Check out how much pressure I'm putting on this, not much. All right, I see right here, you probably can't see it on camera, there's a little bit of thin set I missed, no big deal. I'm gonna get my screwdriver, where is it, here it is. Just a little bit I missed. Scratch that out. And fix that little spot right there. Beautiful. All right, now the corner you have to go, you can't go in a diagonal in the corner, but that's fine. Even if you missed a spot and you came back, you know, tomorrow and realized, oh geez, I missed a spot, no big deal. Mix up a little more grout, fill it in, you'll be fine. All right, that's it. That is it. So now, this is gonna dry. You may see a little bit of a haze. Don't freak out. Tomorrow when you come back, you want this to dry 24 hours. When you come back, literally a paper towel or a rag, like a microfiber rag, something like that, we'll wipe that right off. That's all, you're not gonna have any issues. You do not need to do this. You don't need any other special things. Just what I showed you here is all you really need to do. Now look down here, all sorts of slop that fell down. no big deal. You can wipe it up with your float and reuse that if it isn't dirty, or if it is dirty, you can just put it in your bucket and be done. Now this bucket, if you have two buckets, it's easier. If you have one bucket, you're gonna have to keep rinsing it out and get fresh water. You don't want to let that get too dirty. All right, down here on the bottom, you know, some of the grout gets into that area. You can't help it when you're cleaning up. I'm gonna take a piece of cardboard, anything you have, doesn't matter, and just dig that out, comes right out. All right. Because that is where caulk is gonna go. Incidentally, here's a pro tip for you. You're gonna step in this stuff no matter what you try to do. It's inevitable. I always do it, even though I try not to. And if I have the opportunity, I'll try to wear a boot or a sneaker if I have any that have not much tread on them, so that at least I don't have to dig the grout out of the tread. Okay, that's all finished up with the shower area. So we'll come back when this grout is dry, wipe off the haze, and then I'll caulk the areas that we talked about earlier. Okay, it's been about 24 hours since I grouted, and all I've done so far is to use a damp microfiber rag to wipe down any haze that's left. You can use any cotton rag, it's not that critical. So that's what we look like right now. I'm gonna use this color match caulk. So you can either use a pure silicone caulk, either, you know, white or clear if you wanna do that, or in this case, I'm using a color matched caulk that's matched to the grout color. So this is a tile caulk. I have a whole video about how to do that. And to make a nice clean edge, I will use blue painter's tape to, you know, kind of mark the edges and then caulk, and then you peel the tape off and it makes a nice clean edge. So that's really all that's left. So that's how you grout a vertical surface like a shower wall. And if you have another vertical surface, you know, like a backsplash in a kitchen or anything like that, basically it's the same idea.